Yo, what is up? I wanted to do a video on standalone armor. I was trying to get some for myself, but I wasn't able to try them on, so I ordered a few, and I wanted to see which one I liked the best. What I started out with first was, it's the Liat Airflex Stealth. And this thing's pretty cool. These are armor jackets. That's what they call them, armor jackets, protection jackets. But I wanted something that I could wear separate from a big, huge jacket, right? If you're hot and you take your big, you know, climb jacket off, you lose your pads and it's totally no good, right? So with armor jackets that Liat makes and Alpine Star makes, standalone armor, it's armor that goes on itself and then you wear layers over it. You know, you can, it just adds to the effectiveness of layering system. I really like the layering system. That's what I'm gonna stick to. And I wanted an armor jacket that will help me get to that. It's an off-road thing. A lot of dirt bike riders use it. They go from jerseys to jackets, all that kind of stuff. If you're running on the road, you can wear a Cordura shell over the top. Protect you for the road, so then when you go off-road you don't have to wear all that heavy stuff, right? But I'm gonna get into the different ones I ordered and what I like about it, what I don't like about it, and which one I'm keeping. Airflex Stealth. It's Liat. I'm gonna go ahead and try it on. Whoa! Yeah, so I like it. Pretty dope. Fits real nice. Nice back protector. I dig it. And it's got these kind of cut out elbows there so the fabric doesn't bunch up. But this feels pretty good. You see how it's zipped here, comes up the side and goes over this way, so it's not, you don't have a zipper running down your hard part, down the middle of your chest. But now these are level one, and the back is level one, but not the chest. This is the Airflex Stealth. The only problem I think about it is this elbow padding and shoulder padding is really thin. They say it's level one, but it just seems so thin. And I would think it's level one, or they couldn't say it is, right? But it's just not like the climb level one that you think of. And like even climbs go into this thinner stuff and their new stuff, so I don't know. I really like it, and like under a I don't look like Tron or anything, it don't look like a uniform, and it fits real nice. This is a medium for me, and it fits pretty good. The only problem is it seems so thin. I ordered more to check out. Let me try some more on. It's the Alpine Star Sequence, and it's not bad. This has level one chest, level one back. It has a kidney belt that goes along with it to hold the back protector in place. Kidney belt feels pretty good. And it's got some side, little foam side protection around the kidney area here. And I thought it was pretty cool. I thought it'd be pretty awesome. Let's see what it looks like on. Boom! Yeah, Alpine Star Sequence. I like it. It feels pretty good. Once again, you got the zipper on the side. I feel like Alpine Star zippers is a little bit better. The pads feel good. It fits nice. Now these pads feel a little bigger. Alright, they are bigger. It's more like the climb level one that you would think of, right? The kidney belt feels good. The back brace feels good. It helps. And it just seems pretty good. Thicker pads here. They're nice. My only problem with this is like, you can tell somebody tried this on and like it's just stretched. It's stretched the hell out. Which kind of sucks because you pay to have it come to your house and just to try it on and then somebody's already stretched it all out. And I say it's stretched out because this is a medium. And I ordered a medium in another Alpine Star version and it's so tight, right? It doesn't have like the Liat, the little relief here in the on the elbow. So all this material is bunching up. I really liked it, but except for the material bunching up there. So I was really interested in trying this to see how it was going to fit like that, and you can tell it's just somebody stretched it all out, which kind of sucks, but it's going to stop me from buying it. But like, this is a pretty good option. This is like $200. I think the Stealth, the Lea Air Flex Stealth that I just showed, it's like $250. This is $200, and this would be a really good option. I really think it is, but the one I had sent to me is not the way. But I'll move on to the next one. This is the Alpine Star Bionic Tech V2. And this thing is awesome. The level 2 chest is like breathable. It's got holes to it, you can kind of see. And it's got some nice padding on there. And it just feels pretty good. It's just a little stiff. But the Alpine Star's got level 2 on the chest and back, and then level 1 on the shoulders and the elbows. It's got this abrasion resistance on the elbow, and it's pretty good. Like, I think it would hold up longer. But this is a little thicker level 1 stuff, right? It's more what you're familiar with the climb stuff. And then this is level 1 up here, too. It's not hard plastic. It's that D30 type flex stuff that Alpine Star makes. All right, let me try this one on. This thing is awesome. I really dig this thing. It has tons of protection. It's got the good elbow pads, the good shoulder pads, level 2 chest and back. It fits nice and snug. It's got some padding here in the ribs. Just really good. I really like it. I like the way it fits. It doesn't feel like it's going to move and get loose on me and just like, you know, a couple rides, the pads are all over the place, but it's pretty good. It's got the kidney belt. The kidney belt helps hold the back pad in place. I really like it. I think this is like $269, $279. And I was really tempted to go with this one. Only thing is, like, this here, it kind of bunches up on me. And it's kind of tight. But I think if I ran it a little bit, it would loosen up and be alright, but when I first put it on, it's tight right in here. And the other thing, like, it's got buckles here to come out of the chest plate. The chest and back is part of the thing. You can't just take it off. Which is what people should be doing. These manufacturers should be making just bottom and then be able to buy a chest plate over the top of it. It's got some padding here. It's this here that bothers me, and it's getting in and out of it sucks. One of these off, and one of these off, and then you get to the zipper. Right, the zipper here is in the middle of this one. This was one of my favorites so far. I wanted to try the other Alpine Star one, so I had that sent. And this is the Alpine Star's Bionic Pro version 2. Alpine Star's using the thicker elbow and shoulder pads. I really like that. This one comes with a level, what is it? It's level 1 back. The last Alpine Star was a medium. This was a large. So I was interested to see the difference. Yeah, let's put it on. Okay, I really like this one too, but there's a couple things about it I didn't like. But let me go over the good stuff. Level 1, front and back, shoulders, elbows. Nice. It's the thicker ones on the elbows and the shoulders. Feels good. I don't know if you can see this, but it doesn't sit flush. So I feel like I'm a little exposed in the back. But I really like the chest plate. It's not super stiff, so it's not bad, right? Not too crazy. And it's got the kidney belt that hooks to the back plate to keep it in position pretty good. I think the Alpine Star's zippers are just a little bit better than the Lea. It's got some padding here. It's got a little bit right here on the chest. I really like this. My problem with it is like, these are Velcro. Right, instead of on the last one. To get in and out of this, you gotta do Velcro. And with these chest plates, they're just kind of a pain to get in and out of. They just are, like, it's not the easiest thing. But I like the way the material fits. This is a large, and you can see it's just a little, it moves a little on me. It's not super tight, so I don't know how it would end up. It's a good quality piece, and it's good protection. I don't think this is the right size for me, and I don't know. This almost makes you look like Tron, right? You can see it just stick out way more. So I think this is like $250, $260. So basically for like $20 more, you get the other one. It's better pads, better protection. And it's got abrasion on the elbows and stuff. I think it would just last longer. And it has buckles here. It's probably better. I would probably have to go with the other one over this one. Let's try it. I got one more. And let's show you that one. This one I'm about to show you is the Liat 3DF AirFit Lite. It's very similar to the Stealth, only it's level one in the back and level one in the chest. It has a level one CE rating for the shoulders and elbows. And it's got a little bit in between protection for like the kidney area. It does not have a belt. The two Liats I have do not have a kidney belt. But you can get that from Liat pretty affordable if that's what you're after. And it's also, I didn't show these, but they all have these tabs right here. That's for neck braces to hold the neck brace down. You can also take the pads out of this one. Let's get it on. All right, the 3DF AirFit Lite. I like it. I like it a lot. It's got the holes here, doesn't bunch up, fits nice and tight, doesn't feel like it's gonna go anywhere. And even if it stretches a little, I don't think it's gonna go far at all, but it feels pretty good. I thought these materials are pretty close, but I think Liat's is a little better. And the zippers, I think Alpine Star zippers are a little better. I just like it. It's got level one chest. It's got this little straps on both sides. You can adjust, tighten it up. The protection is good. These are the thicker pads that I'm more used to with like Climb. Even though they're level one, they're a little thicker stuff. I like this. It's easy to get in and out of. I like it a lot. And this is the one I'm going to keep. 3DF AirFit Lite. And all these accommodate neck braces. They have cutouts here and cutouts that you can pull out in the back. I like it. The only problem about this one is the zipper. It's not the easiest thing, but I think I just need to just take it easy with it. So this is what I'm gonna run all the time. I basically wear, what is it, an icebreaker t-shirt underneath. It's a merino wool shirt underneath. I'll wear this, and then I can put any layer of clothes I want over it, and then put a Cordura shell over it to protect me from the street. Climb makes them. I think their Dakar series like that doesn't have any pads in it. Moscow Moto sells a bunch of gear that doesn't have pads in it. It's all for standalone stuff. And that's what, you know, dirt bike riders do. That's Dakar stuff, right? I like it. I think this is good. It's easy to get in and out of. Fits me good. This is a medium. Doesn't feel too tight, doesn't feel like it's gonna stretch out on me. Let me just do a review on all of them, really. The two Alpine Stars, they're badass. I guess I ordered three Alpine Stars. The sequence is pretty cool. It's just, unfortunately, they sent out one that's all stretched out. But I think that's a pretty affordable alternative, you know? To me, I think it's good. And then the other two are super good. I like the, you know, the chest plates, level one and stuff. It's a good idea. I don't know that I'm doing a bunch of roost boosting, people roosting me, so I'm not looking for a roost plate. If you want the most protection, Alpine Star, the Bionic Tech is the good one. It's a little more, it's got a lot of protection in it. You feel pretty good with it, and I think it would last pretty well. There's no question how long these will last, so I'm gonna give it a run for its money though. I don't have a Cordura shell for it, so I'm not gonna run this on my trip. When I come back, I'm gonna start running this. So I can run a jersey or layer up or put rain gear on or Cordura, whatever. Anyway, that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget me, give me a thumbs up if you like the video. And go ahead and subscribe if you want to check some more adventure traveling content. I got my whole run to Cabo coming, so see you on the next one.